It was last week that you said it didn't matter who was in the White House. It mattered about the Fed. But now we do have a president-elect. The market is taking that on board, and we see weakness in the dollar. Is that set to continue?
Yeah, it's gone. I mean, to be fair, through last week, it's gone faster and further than most people would have guessed. There's a sense of euphoria that is going to get punctured by reality. I'm sort of, you know, that there will be a stage of exhaustion, and we will focus on, you know, the economic weakness in Europe that's coming from the second wave of the pandemic. That'll feed through to it. But I do think that, you know, the most important thing about the next few years is that the J. Powell Fed has promised to keep monetary policy extraordinarily accommodative for a long time, and a really long time. And that is why, you know, a rally in the dollar that started all the way back in 2011 should have come to an end and will continue to weaken. Now, the speed of the initial fall is pretty extreme compared to what I thought was going to happen. But I wouldn't change a view that says over the next, you know, year or two, the dollar is going to steadily weaken.
Kit, good to have you with us this morning. Let's just talk about what could interrupt the downward trajectory. One could be a faster vaccine than we all anticipate. Two could be perhaps a more valiant U.S. economy. And that could cause the short end of the curve to reprice. I look at the short end onto your Treasury paper this morning. The market is now the most short since January. Those two Vs, a valiant economy and a vaccine, could reprice the dollar?
A vaccine, I think, would change the nature of the weak dollar because it would broaden it out. If you get a global economic recovery at this point, you'll be in a situation that'll remind you a little bit of 2004-5-6, and money will look for opportunity elsewhere. So if I was an emerging market specialist, I would be really excited about a vaccine coming online right now, because the big investment opportunities with returns anchored in major developed economies is elsewhere. So I think good news on that front, less dramatic. Again, a stronger U.S. economy is only really going to be dollar positive at this point in time when it's a stronger U.S. economy that isn't dragging the rest of the world with it in a really big way. And it's got to be strong enough that we, the market, question the Fed's commitment to lower for longer and to allowing inflation overshoots and so on and so forth. You know, the contrast, if you get a more resilient U.S. economy and weakness in Europe, for example, I think that changes things.
Before we get to the inauguration, though, we do have 2 months left under the Trump presidency. The market at the moment seems to be shrugging off these legal fights. There doesn't seem any substantiated claims that there was widespread substantial fraud. But he still has 2 months left in office, and it has been quite an untraditional presidency. Are there any risks to the market that you'd be watching in these next 2 months?
I think if it all descends into something really ugly as it goes through the courts, if it spreads out, and then that would be something that could affect U.S. asset prices. I think we'll probably take our cue in the foreign exchange market on that from what happens in the U.S. equity market. If the U.S. equity market holds its nerve, and if people think, yeah, okay, this is a period of uncertainty, but we think we know where the destination is, and we think the destination is positive for U.S. equities, then I think the dollar remains under some pressure. But if you got a really significant loss of confidence in particularly the equity market, and particularly perhaps to Manus's point, and maybe with a significant steepening in the yield curve as the long end lost its nerve, I think that could be more tricky, and you may see sort of haven flows back to the dollar. But I think the foreign exchange market isn't instinctively going to say, that there's a really difficult situation with the legal challenge. Let's buy the dollar. It might buy the yen, but not the dollar.